here when it's a 40% off sale and you grab your kit. They are kind of pricey on some of them, though, so make sure y'all try to get a kit that's not, like, overpriced. Y'all, this is Coop in Coop's Corner. We're gonna check out this mall behind me. There's a Box Lunch, Barnes & Noble, and a GameStop. See what they have inside. And it's an FYE. This is the only FYE in the area. So we're gonna check them out and see if they have anything Gundam related or figure related. Let's go inside and check it out. It's Coop, let's do this.
So here at Barnes & Noble's, this one has some pretty dope stuff. I'm gonna cop this for sure. So we got a couple of Gundam Converge, Full Burner, part of this wave as well. So I'm probably gonna cop both of these off rip because I know the heavy arms is pretty hard to find. I have one, and why not? Maybe. We'll see. But I've been looking for some Gundam Converge figs. And first stop of the day, and the Full Burner. So let's go look at the kits. My Funko people, Chase from The Witcher. This is like the first Chase I've seen in a while, in years. This is little Haro, Chains, Mobile Suit, Wing Zero, Zaku, RX, and Unicorn, and a random Naruto anime hero. They got the Mr. Negative and his Inner Demon 2-pack. They have some AEW collabs with Street Fighter with Ken and Ryu. I don't know who these AEW, Nick Jackson and Matt Jackson. Some more AEW figs. Is this the only run? Turtles 2-pack. I know it's Power Rangers, but it's Turtles. That's in there. Some Marvel Legends. Barbecue. Indiana Jones. And some stuff on clearance over here. Medium Death Light for my toy photography people or streamers. Go check that out, see if they, your GameStops have it. And that's pretty much it at GameStop. Not a whole lot. Here at FYE. Pretty dope statues. FYE has always been reliable when it comes to Funkos and statues, but they're just so overpriced, man. $27, depending on the statue, I guess. Some more stuff back here. No, that's just the back of the statues.
Japanese candy and stuff, but snacks. Let's see what else they have. For my DC Universe people, Armor Batman, some Marvel Legends up there. Some more DC Universe. Now this stuff for sure is overpriced.
Dang, $27.
Okay, hold on. Hold on, I'm not tripping. Okay,
close to $50 for US agent.
This is what I mean by like marked up stuff. The Marvel Legends always been marked up. Dormammu, I didn't even have the price on it. Red Skull back there, Nakia. This is on sale. Shuri's on sale. These are the older ones. Star-Lord from the New Wave is going for $40 for Marvel Legends. That's wild. A couple of G.I. Joe's Dusty for $40 as well. And the classic Funko Wall. Ah, man, oh, man, oh, man. I do not miss these days. I do not miss these days. Just taking a glance. Big TLC 3-pack. This is dope. I always wanted this. Burning, glow in the dark. Bulma from Dragon Ball, FY exclusive. Yep, that's it for FYE. They have 40% off model kits, and they have Lupus Rex. It's $25. So roughly around $15 for that. RG Wing Zero, a few Leos. This is the place you go to army build these Leos. Cause one time I bought five, six, and it wound up being like $40-something for six of them, or four of them. I can't remember which ones. Axia Real Grade, another Wing Zero. Perfect Strike Freedom. Goof Custom. Crimson Goof. It's good for dioramas. If you want to build like a diorama and you don't want to waste a kit, you come here when it's a 40% off sale and you grab your kit. They are kind of pricey on some of them though, so make sure y'all try to get a kit that's not like overpriced. Because this was $30 for the Revive. And that's pretty dope. They do have other kits, some Transformer kits, Goof, G.I. Joe Snake Eyes, Starscream. Did I pick up Starscream? I think I do have Starscream. Bumblebee, some Star Wars, some Funkos, not a whole lot. And quick little builds. No Gundam Converge figs for real. Regular standard issue GM. When you go right into the military, they probably give you just this basic one. Action base twos. If these were part of that 40% off sale, I would pick them up, but I don't know if they are or not. You can never have too many action bases. And the Infinity Gundam Infinity Series RX with the Build-A-Figure Zaku. Bath Zaku. G-Frame. GM Command Space Type. Freed Exam. And that's it. Mark II. They stacked on this Mark II. Three of them and a Wing Zero back there. So check your Hobby Lobbies. Check your Hobby Lobbies. These little banks to coin banks. But first, check out Hobby Lobbies. And they have Gundam markers. Hey, people, that wraps up Coop's Corner for this week. And our pickups, we got some pretty dope pickups. Like I said, I found this at Barnes & Noble's. The Heavy Arms Endless Walks Gundam Converge figure. Able to snatch this up. I did put the full burner back because at the end of the day, wanted this, even though I had two, so I didn't want to get the full burner in to complete the set. I hope I don't have like buyer's remorse, but like regret not picking it up. But I'm happy I did find this in the wild, and the homie CD was able to find me one I've been looking for a while. Check out the Undergated podcast this week's episode, and he shows it off which Gundam Converge thing he found for me in the wild in his way. Next up, I did show these off on the Undergated channel a little bit more in depth, but these also came in as well. I picked up the SH Fig Arts Trunks, Boy in the Future, SH Fig Arts. Sun is really blowing this out. But glad to have this in the collection. I've been on my toy photography game, people, so glad to have a Trunks figure. I have the Figurized kit, which is a great kit. It looks amazing. The details on it, you could build the head of regular Trunks and the Super Saiyan head like this. It also comes with both. But with those figures, after a while, you can only do with so much, and they're just like any other type of model kits. It really looks good if you do your really put the time and effort into it, like with the, if you go with shade. And I'm not into the Figurized kits that much to go and paint them, but the SH Fig Arts is in, and also this as well. Oh man, sexy Ultron Gundam P Bandai Metal Robot figure, Ultron Gundam Rufei Season 2. After the engineers upgraded the Shenlong and Death Sight, they dropped this. This is probably everybody's favorite out of all the suits. This and Death Sight, I think, are probably Death Sight Hell. Are probably like, I don't know. Let me know in the comments, people. Do y'all like this version of Ultron or the Endless Waltz version? But this is the metal build figure. I did show it off on the podcast as well. Pulled it out. I'll make it real quick, but I don't know if the glare is gonna kill it. Here it is, comes with a whole lot of accessories, and it comes with this pretty dope stand as well. They all come with a pretty dope stand. I have Wing Zero, Death Scythe, and now Ultron. I don't know if Bandai is going to go down the road of making the metal build. I would believe so to finish off the set. But I don't know if they're going to do Sand Rock and Heavy Arms. If they do, I'll probably pick it up. I did pre-order the Talkies 2 as well. So that's all I have for my pickups on this episode. Again, I appreciate everybody who tuned in. Don't forget, like, share, comment, subscribe. Go check out the Undergated podcast that we dropped yesterday. We're going to try to drop these every Thursday. If not, I'm going to try to drop them sometime either before or after the Wednesday's episode of the podcast. So stay tuned to that. We're doing a lot of big things. I appreciate everybody who tuned in on this. I'm Coop in Coop's Corner. See you next time.